You're watching Unrelent Gaming. This is Beerus, the God of Destruction. Make sure you subscribe to Unrelent Gaming and push the like button for me, or else I'll hakai you from existence.
Oh, and do make sure to watch the entire video all the way through. And follow Unrelent Gaming on both Instagram and Twitter.
Whis, enough. On to the video.
Dragon Ball Super Manga Chapter number 77 is almost here, scheduled to be released in just about 28 to 48 hours, and because of this, we have even more additional news information, updates, spoilers, leaks, and images in regards to what we're about to see go down in this upcoming manga chapter, and more importantly, having to see not only what happened involving Bardock and Monaito and Granola's mother and Granola himself, but now establishing the overall premise of who was behind the entire thing, which we now know it was the Heaters, but there's a little bit of a twist that we're about to see unfold in this upcoming manga chapter, which of course is going to lead into the next manga chapter for Dragon Ball Super Manga Chapter number 78, which, based off of all of the information that we have for chapter 77, chapter number 78 might actually end up being a bloodbath. As a quick little reminder before diving deeper into this video, if of course you guys just so happen to be new to the channel and want to be kept up to date with everything in regards to the Dragon Ball Super manga and the upcoming Dragon Ball Super superhero movie, then I do encourage you guys to go on over and smash that subscribe button and turn on all notifications by clicking on the bell icon to never miss a single video posted on the channel, on top of giving this video a big fat thumbs up by slapping that like button down below if you guys are simply excited to see where the narrative is going to take us moving forward, because courtesy of the Dragon Ball News website and DBS Hype over on Twitter, the following information, leaks, and images for Dragon Ball Super Manga Chapter number 77 goes as follows. Now, as of course you guys can see here on your screen, after later coming to an understanding that Bardock himself was indeed not the bad guy and he wasn't looking to kill Granola or his mom, we take a look at how Bardock here enters Monaito's house, and in his arm, he's carrying an unconscious Granola, which, mind you, the reason why Granola doesn't remember anything is because, number one, the second Granola had went on to look up and noticing Grade 8 Bardock having to poke his head through the church, that was all that was needed in knocking the kid out, because out of sheer fear alone, Granola had fainted and remaining unconscious for the time being. Now, what's even more interesting about all of this is both Granola's mother and Monaito are really beginning to question Bardock's intentions in kind of asking him why he's doing this. Now, the excuse behind this may not resonate with some of you guys, because some of you guys might say that it's piss poor writing, or perhaps maybe it's just lazy, which I don't blame you guys for, but until we have the official translations, it looks as though the reason why Bardock is doing this is because he has somewhat of a hunch that something bad is going to happen involving Frieza, so he has this whim that they must survive. He doesn't really give a reason as to why. Monaito asks him for his name, and then Bardock gives his name. As of course you guys can see here, there is a touching moment involving Granola and his mom and Monaito being happy, and I'm sorry, I still blame Monaito for a lot of this, and I'm going to explain later as to why, but it's interesting to see how Bardock is the only Saiyan among the others involving Taro and Leek and all of the other invaders who is actually remorseful enough to spare them, which, mind you, when going back to the present, Vegeta, out of all people, went on to tell Goku that perhaps maybe he was the one that had inherited this kindness from Bardock himself, right? Which, Goku's reaction to all of this is a little wonky, but we're gonna get into that as, of course, we continue. So, speaking of, as of course you guys can see here, Granola looks surprised, Monaito continues his story, and Goku and Vegeta seem to really be immersed in this entire situation, in this story that Monaito is telling, because they seem to be invested until Monaito tells Goku, hey, by the way, you kind of look like that guy, in which, as of course you guys can see right here, Vegeta is the one that confirms that, yeah, Bardock is Goku's dad, which we've known and seen in the spoiler summary preview, so that's interesting to see how Vegeta knew about Bardock, but Goku, he's shocked and surprised, Granola is shocked and surprised, Monaito is weirdly shocked and surprised, even though Monaito had seen Bardock before, and Bardock looks just like Goku, just like how Goku looks like Bardock, so wouldn't that kind of go hand in hand for Monaito to say, hey, you kinda look like that guy, but even after Vegeta revealed, hey, that's your dad, all of a sudden Monaito's shocked, it's just a little weird to me, but Granola, he wants to more or less know what the hell happened to his mom, because okay, if Bardock made the save, than what happened to his mom. And what's even more interesting is the heaters, once they end up arriving, they're the ones that play a big role in this entire thing, because essentially enough, they are responsible for this mess to begin with, in which, as of course you guys can see here on your screen, when Bardock quickly notices that all four of these Heater Klansmen members are actually making their way towards him, he puts on this hood, and the first thing that Elec asks him is for his name, which Bardock does not give up. But ultimately enough, what Elec does is he's asking what he's about to do, and Bardock lies by telling Elec, hey, I just so happen to have found these survivors and I'm going to get rid of them. So instead of actually playing into Bardock's narrative, Elec is actually saying, okay, well then do it. Kill them. And Bardock is really hesitant, because it really didn't take long for Elec to kind of figure out that Bardock was lying to him, because Elec had told him, alright, do it, and Bardock is very hesitant on doing it. So immediately when you put two and two together, you can kind of already get an idea as to what's really going on here. So instead, Elec ends up taking matters into his own hands. He pulls out a gun and he fires the first shot. So he's of course the ringleader, he's the brains of the operation, but by no means is he going to hesitate in taking the opposition down, because as soon as Elec ended up firing this gun, Bardock panicked because he didn't know who he shot, right? So we ultimately find out, and it in fact is none other than Granola's mother. So he shoots Granola's mom, I'm only assuming somewhere near her heart, and as Monaito is clutching onto an unconscious Granola, she goes down. Bardock is shocked, Monaito is shocked. Nobody really knows what to do right now, because this was it. Monaito does not have the ability to heal her in any kind of way, so she perishes right there by the hands of the same person that Granola was working for this entire time, and not knowing that it was him that murdered his mom. It was them that hired, essentially, the Saiyans and Frieza in doing their dirty work so they can sell this planet for a higher bidder. Which, even then, Elec was looking to screw Frieza by undercutting his pay as well, right? So, these guys are malicious, they're dirty, and they play into some dirty tactics, which Bardock was not having any of it, because as soon as Bardock attempted to attack the heaters, out of nowhere, Gas ends up stepping in by creating somewhat of a barrier and protecting himself from this massive explosion or attack that Bardock had launched towards their direction, which ultimately tells me that it looks as though Gas might be the one. Gas is going to be that guy that's going to do the fighting for them, which we kind of already knew to an extent, because we saw Oil fight, he was fodder. We never saw Maki fight to an extent. All she really did was head scissor Granola, and Elec really hasn't been shown doing much of anything when it comes down to just straight combat, so he's the brains of the operation, like mentioned, so it's going to be Gas. If we're going to be going into the next chapter with Granola seeking vengeance, it's probably going to be against Gas, and whatever wish they're about to make, it's probably going to be for Gas nonetheless, right? Which, speaking of wishes, as of course you guys can see here, Elec has one of the Dragon Balls, which to me is a little weird considering how this entire time Goku and Vegeta and Granola have been fighting, and it gave them enough time to find the last Dragon Ball, but they didn't, because they were simply observing and hovering above the atmosphere and taking a look at planet Sorrel, so now they're going to get it. But here's something interesting that happens at the beginning of this chapter, which, as of course you guys can see here, this Sorrelian right here is the Sorrelian that was responsible for destroying the moon that caused all of the great apes in reverting back down into their humanoid forms, right? And the move that he actually ends up using is a similar move that Granola was just about to use against Vegeta in the previous manga chapter. So that was something that I found to be very interesting, because as of course you guys can see, it's the same exact gun-like pose, it's the same exact kanji for the move as well, the aura is similar, the little light that surrounds the aura is also similar, and I think that it's really interesting to see how it appears like all of these Sorrelians seem to be sharing a common move, and this looks to be one of those common moves that perhaps maybe a lot of these Sorrelians share, which for the most part I think is really cool in the fact that Toriyama and Toyotaro are continuing to world build by creating this new civilization and giving them really unique moves that all of them seem to share. So I can't wait to see how they end up using this against the great apes, specifically before having to destroy the moon, because there is so much more coming, and I can't wait to show you guys within the next 24 hours or so, because this is going to be absolute pandemonium, I believe, from start to finish, especially once the Saiyans actually end up arriving on planet Sorrel. But in the end, I want to go on ahead and get your thoughts in the comment section below in regards to two things. Number one, the heaters, because it looks as though Gas is going to be that dude. Gas is going to be that fighter, because he was the one that protected his clan. He was the one that fought Bardock. He was the one that wants to essentially get revenge for what happened 40 years ago, hence why in the previous chapters, he kind of had an unsettling feeling, right? Because Bardock beat his ass before, so of course he might want to take revenge on the next best thing, which is probably going to be Goku. And you can ultimately bet your bottom dollar that I'm pretty sure Alek is gonna sick Gas on all of them, if of course Gas ends up getting strong enough and fighting all three of them at once, because based on from what it looks like, Alek is the puppet master, the others are basically support units, while Gas is going to be that main dude. So thoughts on Gas, thoughts on the heaters, and also thoughts on Granola and what he's going to do next, because remember, we are going to be covering the entirety of this manga chapter in English on Wednesday, October 20th, so you guys don't want to miss out on everything, including all of the dialogue that's going to be presented forward with accurate translations for us to kind of get a better understanding as to what's to be expected in chapter 78, because I can promise you this, if this chapter ends off with Granola accepting what is, and he then takes initiative in hunting down the heaters, I'm telling you all right now, this is going to be a bloodbath if Granola comes across the heaters in chapter 78 come November 20th. So again, thank you all so much for watching, thank you all so much for your time. If you guys are new to the channel, then be sure to go on ahead and smash that subscribe button, and turn on all notifications by clicking on the bell icon to never miss a single video posted on the channel. Hit this video up with a big fat thumbs up by slapping that like button down below if you guys are simply excited to see what's about to happen next, because I definitely think there's so much more to this story than what we're seeing right now. Hopefully, through proper constructive writing and good pacing, we might actually see one of the best stories unfold, but again, that really varies on Toriyama and Toyotaro to take this story to the next level, right? So I can't wait to see you guys back here on Wednesday, and I can't wait to see how this is going to unfold. So once more, I appreciate you guys for your time. Tune back in for more, and on that note, I'll be seeing you all down in the comment section below and in the next video. Take it easy, guys, and have a great day. Peace. And a quick little reminder before you exit the video, if you guys are unaware, follow me on my secondary channels, which are also used to discuss and talk about all kinds of different subjects and topics, including gaming and live streams, beginning with Unreal Network, which is a channel dedicated in discussing all kinds of movies, breakdowns, current events, scary stories, theories, and more. So if you are someone who is into the entertainment world, then that's the channel for you. So head on over and subscribe over on Unreal Network, which up next is Unreal Vlogs, where I bring you guys a little closer into my life in taking you behind the scenes with vlogging content, parody videos, reactions, motivational videos, uplifting videos, and more. So if you want to get to know me on more of a personal level, then that's the channel for you. Hit that subscribe button to always be in the loop with Unreal Vlogs. And lastly, my gaming channel, Unreal Royale, where on that channel we dive more into the world of gaming, ranging from all different kinds of video games, from Dragon Ball to Resident Evil to Grand Theft Auto, Halo, Gears of War, Minecraft, all kinds of horror games, shooters, RPGs, and more, including live streams. So if you're a gamer and are into the gaming world, then smash that subscribe button over at Unreal Royale and experience the ride with me. I want to thank you all so much for your time. Thank you all so very much for your support, and I'll be seeing each and every single one of you in the next video.
This is the Galactic Emperor of the Universe, and of course I'm here to tell you to subscribe to Unrelent Gaming.
Also follow Unrelent Gaming on these social media platforms to stay connected at all times. And if you don't, then very soon you will all be dead! Oh, did someone say Unrelent Gaming? Oh my god!
The fuck, Zarbon? Put on some clothes!
Well, why don't you put on any clothes?
What? I don't need clothes! Jesus Christ, that's huge! What, Broly?
Frieza.
Uh-oh.
Prepare to die!
Boo, I'm a real gaming! But once you get video, I'll let some likes! Or Boo will turn you into chocolate!
Vados, get over here! Tell these mortals that I'm the biggest Unreal Engine gaming fan! This is my moment! I'm a part of his notification squad! Universe 7 can have all the fun! I just want the food!
And don't forget to leave a comment on this video! Show some love for the best community on YouTube!
Kakaroter!